She promised me that we were going to go through the Concrete and Crane song. You know, sometimes people just don't always follow on their promises. That's just our human nature. But do you know what? Jesus always follows through on his promises. And we're going to learn more about that today, day 3, Vacation Bible School. I hope you had a great time learning our verse. Don't forget, Philippians 1:6.
your story. Come on, listen.
I needed rescue, my sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, now you call me a citizen of heaven. Where I was broken, you were my healing. Now your love is the air that I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open, 'cause when you call my name, shout it, I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day. You call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Oh, come on, hey.
How do you work this thing? Oh, hi y'all, sorry. I am Miss Sandy, and I'm here today to tell you a really exciting story. Jesus was arrested for sins that he didn't commit. He was beaten. He was nailed to the cross where he died. It took his body down from that cross and placed it in a tomb and rolled an enormous stone over the door so that no one could get in, no one could get out. And they even placed guards outside that door, or the stone, to make sure that happened. Now, that's not really the exciting part. That's kind of discouraging. And the followers of Jesus believed that their hope was gone, that was the end of that. So I'm going to read to you from Matthew 28, or share with you what happened next. And this is where it gets really exciting. So I'm in the first verse of chapter 28, Matthew. Early on Sunday morning, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, walked to the tomb. Think about how they're feeling. They know what happened. They saw what happened. And there was a violent earthquake, and an angel of the Lord had come down from heaven. The angel rolled back the stone that had been placed in front of the tomb and sat on it. Now picture this, okay? The angel had the appearance of lightning, and his clothes were as white as snow. Think if you were those ladies. Think about how you felt getting there and what you saw. I don't know exactly how I would feel. The guards who'd been placed in front of the tomb were so frightened that they fainted and fell out on the ground. Told you it was going to get exciting. Well, when the women saw the angel, they were frightened. So the angel reminded them that Jesus had risen just as he had told them he would. The angel invited the women to come see. Come to the tomb and see, and then go tell Jesus' disciples what you have seen. Now, on the way, Jesus met the women, and he said, "Don't be afraid. Go and tell my disciples to leave for Galilee, and they'll see me there." The women took off. They ran to tell the great news. Jesus is alive! They told the disciples to go to Galilee, where Jesus would meet them. The 11 disciples traveled to the mountains in Galilee where Jesus had directed them to go. When the disciples saw Jesus, they worshiped him. Jesus said to them, "Go and make disciples everywhere. Baptize people and teach them to do everything I've told you." Then Jesus made an amazing promise. He promised to be with them always. Now,
Jesus wasn't just talking to those 11 men. He was talking to his disciples. Guess what I am? Guess what you are? We're all disciples. And he's telling us, he's giving us a command to go and tell everyone about all the things he said and done. But the even more exciting part is that he told them that he would be with them always. But again, that's also us. It's a promise to us, and God doesn't take promises lightly. He promised that he would be with us always.
Hello, welcome to day 3. I hope that you have had a wonderful time during Vacation Bible School. You know, we have had some really great Bible stories, but I do want to touch on a couple that Miss Brandy and Miss Sandy have told you. You know, Miss Brandy talked about how Jesus went and prayed in the garden. And on that night, Jesus was having his conversation with God, praying with him, talking about his death on the cross, foreshadowing what's going to come next, okay? And then Miss Sandy talked about after he died on the cross, he rose again 3 days later. And so I want us to talk about why Jesus died on the cross. Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And sin, that means all the things that we do that aren't right, that are bad, that God doesn't appreciate, okay? And it's really hard. And I'll just be completely honest, we will always do that. We will, because it's a struggle. We're human. However, Jesus died on the cross, rose again on the 3rd day, and we can have new life in him. All right, Miss Sandy talked about becoming a disciple of Jesus. So what does that mean? What does that look like to be a disciple of Jesus? That means accepting Jesus into your heart, saying, Lord, I know I'm a sinner and I want to turn away from that and I want to follow you. So here's some easy ways that you can remember on how to kind of walk yourself through that. And you want to make sure that you really do believe this in your heart and in your mind. It's not something you just decide to do because it's cool or because your friend's doing it. It's something that you decide to do because you know Jesus is telling you, okay? If you do choose to make this decision, I want you to make sure and tell your mommy and daddy too, okay? So, you know, the letters of the alphabet, A, B, C. Well, we've got some cool things to pair with that. A, admit. Admit that you are a sinner, okay? Admit to God that, you know, I haven't done the right thing. The very first people that God created, they chose to sin, and that separated them from God, okay? So, second one, B, believe. Believe that Jesus came, died on the cross for your sins, and rose again, okay? That he is the gift that you've been given, and he is the way to eternal life, life again with him. So we accepted that we're a sinner, okay, and that we've been separated from Jesus and God, but we believe that Jesus is the way to be connected again. And then C, confess. Confess that that you did that wrong thing, that you have sinned, but that Jesus is our Christ, our Savior, and our Lord. We want to proclaim that, okay? And so I know that this is a big decision. I don't want to make you make this decision. Remember, this decision needs to be between you and Jesus. What is he telling you to decide, okay? So if you choose to make this decision right now, Jesus loves you, God loves you. Sin is choosing your way instead of God's way, but God sent Jesus so that you wouldn't have to die for your sins, all the bad things that you've done. Jesus has died for those, and we want to accept that, knowing the truth of Jesus Christ. So I've said a lot of things. I want you to sit and process them for a little bit, but I want us to pray. And first, I'm going to pray for Vacation Bible School. Second, I'm going to help you pray our prayer, accepting Jesus into your heart. Okay? So if you choose to say that prayer, then you can say it with me. And then we'll go from there. Okay? So first, I'm going to pray for Vacation Bible School. Father God, you are good. And I thank you for Vacation Bible School. I thank you for all of the people that have helped, all of the kids that are hearing these stories, Lord. And I thank you for the love of Jesus and the sacrifice that he made for our sins on the cross. Father, you are good. He rose again on the third day, and he has given us new life. Father, I pray for the rest of the week. Help us to have fun. Help us to feel your love. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Second, this is our prayer of salvation. If you are choosing to ask Jesus in your heart, I want you to pray this prayer with me, okay? So, here we go. Bow your head. Dear God, I know that I'm a sinner. I'm ready to become a Christian. I know that I've sinned, and my sin separates me from you. I'm sorry for my sin. I believe Jesus died on the cross for me, and my sin can be forgiven. I believe Jesus rose from the dead and is alive. God, please forgive me. I ask Jesus to come into my life and be my Savior and my Lord. I will obey you and live for you for the rest of my life. Thank you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. You are now a Christian, and I am so excited for you. If you decided to pray this prayer to accept Jesus in your heart, I want you to go tell your mommy or your daddy, your grandmother or your grandfather, and then tomorrow I want you to come up to the church and tell me. I want to know. I am so excited that we have gotten to do Vacation Bible School together. Have a great day.
I challenge you to a duel.
Hi, Miss Nancy here. And if you're kindergarten through second grade, this is your craft for today. When a construction worker or a carpenter is working on a project, they like to have all their tools close at hand. So they will often use a tool belt or a tool apron to keep everything they need for their project right where they need it. In your packet for today, you have your own tool belt. It looks like this. You can put the supplies that you need in your tool belt. It might be your crayons or a marker. A tablet to write notes on. Oh, my tool belt has a picture of me in my construction uniform. And the last thing I have is a ruler. This is a special ruler, and you can make your own ruler from your packet. All you have to do is take your brad and connect the ruler parts. Look what happens when I turn the ruler. It turns into a cross. You know, you can measure a lot of things with a ruler, but one thing that you can't measure with a ruler is Jesus' love for you. So whenever you use this ruler, just remember how much Jesus loves you.
Hi-ya! Hi-ya! Hi-ya!
Hello, welcome back to VBS. I'm Miss Regina, and we are on day 3. And if you're in grades 3 through 6th grade, 3rd through 6th grade, this is the craft for you today. It is a string art cross. I bet you've seen these before. I think they're kind of fun to do. So in your packet today, you should have found a board, several nails, a cross pattern, and some embroidery thread or yarn or whatever you have. So the first thing that you're going to do is take those nails and your cross pattern, okay, and lay it on the cross. So that's the first thing. Then you're going to take those nails, and you need a hammer, and if you need some help, ask mom or dad, and you're going to put the nails at every corner of the cross, even inside here, okay? And that makes that cross, all right? And so the next thing, you're going to take your string, yarn, embroidery thread, pull it out, and you will need to tie a knot around this first nail, okay? Then all you're going to do is make the outline of the cross. So you have it here, and you're going to bring it down here and just wrap it around. You don't even have to tie a knot. So it's just going to kind of come here and around and back around this middle nail, down to the bottom, over, back up, around here, and all the way up and over. Now, when you get here, you can stop if you want, but I kind of like to go two more times to make it thick. So I did it again, and then I think I did it even a third time. And when I got up here, I actually went back down and made this cool little X right here in the middle. It just kind of makes it pop right there. And I think that that looks really good. So anyway, when you end up, where whatever nail you end on, just tie it around there and tie a knot so that it stays in place. And that's your string art cross. It's not too difficult, and I think it looks really neat. And the thing that I want you to know today is that I would love if you had somebody special that you would like to give this to, and they could even put a hanger on the back if they wanted, but even if you just lay it on the table. But I think it would be a nice way for you to tell somebody else about Jesus. Jesus died on the cross for you and me, and when he rose from the grave, he found his disciples, and he gave them this promise that he would be with them always. And if you accept Jesus as your Savior, you have that promise, and you will always be with Jesus, because when you die, you will go to heaven and you will live with him eternally. And that's what he means. I will be with you always to the end of the age. And so I think that's a neat thing that you could give somebody your testimony about how much you love Jesus and what he did for you and for me and for that person that you're giving this to. I hope you have a fun day.
Hello. My name is Isabel Smith, and I am the Children's Ministry Intern here at FBC Salado. Thank you for joining us for our virtual VBS. We look forward to seeing you all today as you drive through at the church to pick up your snack from 10:30 to 11:30, and today we will have live worship on a stage in the parking lot. Come join us. Also, work on your memory verse, and if you can say it for us any day this week at snack pickup, we have a special prize for you. Don't forget to post pictures of you doing VBS activities at home. Use our hashtag, and you can see it on the screen, FBC Salado VBS 2020. We will be back with another virtual VBS tomorrow. We love you at First Baptist Salado. Thank you for coming. Have a great day.